Hello children, in today's video we are going to see about the transfer of heat through radiation and advection, and we are also going to see about the factors affecting temperature under the chapter elements of weather and climate. Let's get started. So this is the third method by which heat is transferred to the atmosphere from the earth's surface. This radiation, it is the energy that is transmitted from one body to another in the form of rays or waves. Okay, so this is the diagram, that is the Earth's energy budget. So in this diagram, it is clearly shown from the sun the incoming solar energy. Now what happens, it is radiated back to the space, the clouds and the atmosphere. It is directly radiated to the space from the Earth. So we are seeing this red color arrows, which is showing about the how much it is radiated back to the atmosphere. So this the earth absorbs heat from the sun and it gives off this heat in the form of the infrared rays, so which is absorbed by the atmosphere and heated up. The next one is the heating through advection, the transfer of heat from one region to the another. So the warm winds, it mix with the cooler winds, so the heat energy is passed on from the warmer winds to the cooler winds. So basically the advection, it involves the large scale horizontal transfer of energy. The example is the cold polar winds. It mix with and cool the warmer air of the tropics. So this particular advection, this heating through advection, we will see in detail in the chapter pressure and winds, that is the next chapter. So we'll move on to the factors affecting temperature. We are going to see about the temperature, which is one of the main element of the climate and weather. From the equator to the poles, the earth experiences a wide range of temperatures. So the factors that affect the temperature of a place are the latitude, altitude, distance from the sea, upper air currents or the prevailing winds, ocean currents, and the industrial emissions and concretization. First one is the latitude. In this picture you can see the incoming sunlight. Okay, so you can see the 0 degree marked there, 90 degree north, 90 degree south, which is denoting the poles, and the 0 degree, it's denoting the equator. So the sun's rays, it strikes the surface of the earth at different angles. So you can see the angles here, the different angles at from the equator to the poles. So while the equatorial region, if you see the equatorial regions, it will get the vertical rays of the sun. But if you see the polar regions, it is getting the slanting rays of the sun. The incoming sunlight is the same equal amount of sunlight only they are receiving. But when it is receiving it here vertically, it is getting, the equatorial region is getting much more sunlight. Okay, the temperature here, it is very high. The heating provided by the same amount of the sunlight is more in the equatorial region when it is compared to the higher latitudes. So hence the temperature, it decreases towards the poles. So that is why there is a permanent cover of ice at the poles. So amount of sunlight received at the poles are less when it is compared to the equator. The next one is the altitude. So the altitude, always what we do, we plan for a summer trip to the hilly regions in order to avoid the scorching heat of the plains. Moreover, we are in the flat plains. If you are in the flat plains, we are far away from the sun. But we, as we climb the hill, we are much closer to the sun. So that is what we are going to see here. This is because the temperature decreases with increase in the altitude. So what is altitude? Altitude is nothing but the height. Okay, when it is reference to the planetary surface, it is the extension upward, the distance upward. Okay, so as you are moving high, the temperature decreases. So for every 1 kilometer of ascent, there is a decrease of 6.5 degrees Celsius. Okay, so the temperature decreases with the increase in altitude, that is the height. Why this is happening? So the air is densest near the ground and it thins rapidly with the height. So as you move high, the density of the air decreases That only we learned in the troposphere, the layers of the atmosphere, the previous lesson. So when the air is dense, more heat is trapped. Okay, it retains the heat. So we are feeling that heat. So as the air is thin, when the atmosphere is thin, if it is not dense, what happens? More the heat escapes. So therefore, more the altitude of a place, the colder it will be. That is why we prefer to go to a hilly region during the summer. Yes, so in the next video we will be seeing in detail about the other factors affecting the temperature, that is distance from the sea, prevailing winds, ocean currents, and the industrial emissions and the urbanization and deforestation in detail. Thank you, children.